welcome to this Ivanti video that will give you a quick overview of the concept behind License Optimizer. There's a lot of money to be made from software licenses, and possibly for this reason, software licensing can be complicated, especially if you have a large IT estate with a lot of computers running a lot of software. And while I can't guarantee that License Optimizer will make your software licensing any less complicated, it can help you to manage your software and licensing data and enable you to determine your effective license position. When you have this, License Optimizer can help you to optimize the usage of the licenses you have, determine where you have too many or too few licenses, and then enable you to make informed decisions during renewal. Ivanti maintains a Definitive Software Library, or DSL. This is a library of software titles that are available and which are used to match against your own software inventory and license data. Currently, in fall 2018, the Ivanti DSL contains 7,000 vendors with over 80,000 products, over 120,000 versions, and well over 250,000 SKUs or individual items. This is being added to continually. In addition to this DSL, you create your own for software titles that are less common or which are specific to your estate. There are a lot of advanced features in License Optimizer that are designed to help you to get the best deal for your licenses. You can read about those features in the online help, and more videos will be coming along to cover them also, but in this video I'm just going to give you the very big picture of how License Optimizer works so that you have a foundation to build more advanced concepts and features onto. Before you start, the best strategy is to decide on a vendor or a set of products that you would like to take a closer look at. A good initial objective could be to look at Microsoft licensing or a vendor that you are due to renew against next or in the near future. The first step is to discover or import all of your hardware and software information into License Optimizer. Software is often licensed with respect to the number of times it is installed, so we want to associate the software records with matching hardware records, also known as OSIs, or Operating System Instances. When you import software records into License Optimizer, it automatically matches these software titles to titles in the DSL, so that it knows exactly what software you have. Sometimes, however, it can't automatically match your software, so you need to teach it to match your software with the correct title in the DSL. And sometimes you will have software that the DSL doesn't know about, so you can add it to your personal DSL. The important thing here is to focus any teaching exercises on the specific vendor or product that you intend to analyse. And then you import your user data, because some licences are for named users. When you have your hardware, software and user data in License Optimizer, you import your license data. Your vendors can supply you with this. Again, License Optimizer matches the software titles in your license data with software titles in the DSLs, and again, sometimes it can't automatically match your licenses, so you need to teach it to match your licenses with the correct title in the DSL. Now that License Optimizer has all your data, it can reconcile everything to determine an initial effective license position, or ELP. License Optimizer's rules engine intelligently assigns licenses to give the optimal license position, and you can see where your organization is under-licensed and at risk of a compliance audit, or over-licensed and wasting money on unnecessary software purchases. Typically, your initial reconciliation gives a disappointing ELP, but don't worry. This is the result that you would have presented at an audit, which would have been a bit uncomfortable in front of the vendor, but it's not a problem now that you know about it and have time to address it. This result is usually because your data is incomplete or in the wrong shape. Fortunately, we have experience in this process and understand many of the common problems and have developed some strategies to help. I'm going to cover some of those strategies in future videos, so be sure to subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss them. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful.